That was Eat the Rich by Crocus off of their 1983 album Headhunter. I've never listened to Crocus before. That was very pretty just straight up heavy metal, I would say. Probably maybe even a little bit of hair metal. I haven't seen what these guys look like, but definitely feel like in that vein of the kind of like hard rock heavy metal lean. And Eat the Rich itself, the lyrically wasn't as profound as the title would insinuate. The chorus consisted of, eat the rich, don't you know life is a bitch. We're listening to that today because we have two Thrash Bash songs from 1983 in competition today. And these songs will probably be much better than that song was. Hi, my name is Bean and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 82 of the Thrash Bash tournament today, and that is match 18 in round 2. So we're over halfway done with round 2. We're getting done with the tournament. It's happening, slowly but surely. First, I'll explain what we're doing here. We took the first 4 albums from the big 4 of thrash metal. That's Anthrax, Megadeth, Metallica, and Slayer. And we threw the songs into a single elimination-style tournament. We plucked out anything that was instrumental, anything under 2 minutes, and covers, besides a couple that snuck through. And we took out a couple extras just to get it down to a nice, neat 128-song tournament. And now they've been doing battle and head-to-head competition until there's one remaining in the end, and that'll be the very best song released by the big 4 of thrash metal in the 80s. Today, we've got two of the strongest bands going head-to-head off of their debut albums. We're starting off with Cryonix, which was released by Slayer on Show No Mercy, released in 1983. This is a song about cryogenics, freezing people, basically, and preserving them. Last round, that defeated Make Me Laugh by Anthrax. Its competition today is Jump in the Fire, released by Metallica on their 1983 debut album, Kill 'Em All. Last round, Jump in the Fire also defeated Anthrax. It took down Medusa. Anthrax has been kind of a whipping boy through most of this tournament. And rightly so. We're here to compare these two songs and see which one's the better of the two, so let's go ahead and get into it. Here is Cryonix.
Dream.
pretty kind of like unextraordinary for the most part. The solos at the end are super good, like, but the last half of it is pretty much just instrumental soloing, which is pretty cool, being that the song is only 3.5 minutes. That makes for about a minute and 45 seconds of just shredding on guitars, which is cool, but the song itself isn't really fully remarkable, I would say. Let's compare it to Jump in the Fire. Here's Jump in the Fire.
Jump in the fire.
that was pretty much a pop song. The verse, chorus, verse structure was solely there. It had the very like structured sound to it. It was really good. The riff was super catchy. Definitely something you could get a whole crowd of people dancing to, especially these days where everybody's used to like heavy music now. That would be easy to just throw on the radio or throw on, you know, in the background, and people are gonna they're gonna dig it. Even though it's like 80s thrash metal, they're gonna groove to it. That was a good song. I'm gonna give that one a jump in the fire. Cryonics was decent enough, but it didn't really do much to, you know, grab you for the long term. Whereas Jump in the Fire has a lot more just like catchy energy to it. It pulls you into the song. And doesn't let you go, really. We've got social media if you want to talk about it. We've got Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. There's also a TikTok account if you feel like these videos are a bit too long and you wish they were shortened down. Check out the TikTok account. I'll link the songs as well as the tournament bracket down in the description of the video, but if you look down below me here, you'll see the tournament bracket URL has appeared, and you can type that into any web browser and check it out that way as well. We have a Venmo and a Cash App, and if you want to donate $10, you can get one of these No Ringo, No Life buttons. Just make sure to include an address with that donation. Like the video if you like the video, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Share with anyone you know who might be into this kind of content, and let me know down in the comments which of these two songs you would have chosen if it were you in the hot seat today. That's all the thrashing and bashing we've got going on for the day, and thanks for doing that with me. But I hope you want to chill out with us here in just a minute over with Juliana Barwick. In fact, it might be going right now. Hope you all have a great night, fantastic afternoon, and a wonderful morning. Bye.